Hey, hi everyone. Welcome back to another video, Java for Selenium. In this video, we'll mainly focus on how to pass parameters and how to return the values from the method. So if you are really interested to build a very healthy framework in Selenium, then this topic has to be cleared, because in framework, we'll mainly deal how we can accept the values and from the different methods and how we can pass these parameters dynamically. So let's get started with the high level agenda. So we'll see what is parameters, how to pass parameters, how to return the values from the methods. So what is parameters? First of all, to make our program dynamic, we can pass parameters while calling methods. So parameter can be compile time and runtime as well. Like if you need parameters at the runtime from the users, then yes, it's possible. If you want to pass parameter at compile time, that is also possible. So how to pass parameters? So this is the previous method that we created, hard-coded method. You need to pass the data inside it. But now let's take another method where you want to accept A and B from the user. And A and B will be received, and we will do the addition operation. So how to pass these parameters? When you call this method using object, so let's say I'm calling this method obj.sum, I can pass the 6789. So 67 will be stored into A, 89 will be stored in B, and we can use these values inside this method and we can use it. So let me show you. So I will create another package. I will say parameter demo. Inside this package, I will create another class called pass parameter. Take public static void main. So let's say I have one method called addition and one method as subtraction. These methods are hard-coded now, like I need to pass the data inside the methods only. But I can parameterize them, like if I give you certain values, then you can perform the operation, let's say A plus B. And you can say, hey, result is C. So these are dynamic in nature. Now you need to pass this A and B from the main method. Now let's take one more example. I have addition, subtraction method. And this time I will take some double value. I need to use fractional values. And I will say here, result equal to x, y minus x. Whatever result it will be, I will print here and I will say subtraction result is plus result. Now we are done with the method creation, but what about passing these parameters? To pass the parameters, as we know, because these methods are non-static, we need to create object of our class. I will create object, first of all, class name, obj1, object name, whatever object name you want to pass. Again, class name, followed by parenthesis and semicolon. Now you can use this obj1.addition. So now while calling this method, Java will ask you, please pass two parameters because it is accepting two parameters. So I will say yes. So when you run your program, 445 will be copied into A, 78 will be copied into B, and it will perform operation. You will get this result. Now if you run this program, you will get the result 533. But you did not get subtraction because we have not called from the main method. So I will call it now, and I will say subtraction. I will say 17789.65. Y value I will give 6056.65. So if I run this, you can see I'm getting the result. Here logic I will change. I will change x minus y. Now it will behave correctly. So this is your result. So now we have seen how to pass parameters and how we need to pass the value while calling methods. Now let's take one example. Right now, let me show you what exactly I want to do now. I want to return some values because right now these values are not coming to my main class, or you can say the main method. These C value, so this variable C, if I want to access here, let's say if I want to access C, I'm not able to access because these are the local variables and these have the body till here. So once this body is finished, we cannot use this C variable anyone either in this method, either in the main method. But now I want to utilize this, so I need to return these values. So this is the actual concept. So let's say this is our method right now and we are doing some operation. Now let's say I want to return this value. So if you see, in spite of void, I have written int, and I need to add one more keyword called return C. As the name says, it will return the value from this method. So when I call this method, it will return me the value and I will store into a variable. Let me show you what we are trying to perform now. So I will copy this program and I will paste, and I will say pass parameter 2. And this time I will change the return type. Previously it was void. Void means it will not return anything, but I want to return the value now. So when I say return the value, I need to add return C. Return C means whenever it will perform operation, it will return a value C from here. So the respective caller has to accept this. So who is the respective caller as of now? Respective caller is this obj1.add. So now if you put mouse over, it will show you, like, it will accept integer A, integer B, and it will return you an integer result. Yes, I will say thank you, and whatever result you are getting, so it is equal to the addition. So whatever result it will calculate, it will store all the result into some variable, and this time I want to print, I will say sum result is sum. Previously, I was not able to access because these variables were limited till this particular method. So right now, we are returning this value from here. So when I call this method, it will evaluate and it will get the result. Result I will store in sum and we will get this. In a similar way, I have this method as well. But in this method, the return type will change because the data which I have is kind of double. So result which I want to return is, it is a kind of double. So I will say this method will return you a double value. So I will say okay. I will accept in a double variable and I will say result obj1.subtraction. So when you run this program, it will call this subtract method. It will return the data from here and whatever data will come, it will store into this result variable, and then I will print here. So now you can see we are able to return the values. Okay, and if you don't want to use into a single class, what you can do, let's create one more class. It will be very easy for you. Again, I will create a separate class and I will say dynamic calculator. I will not take this public static void main because I don't want to run this particular class. I only want to have these two methods here. So now whenever you have to use it, now you can remove from here. And now we know these methods are available in dynamic calculator class. What I will do now, I will create object of that class, that's all. I'm creating object of that particular class and I'm calling that methods, it will return me the value and I'm simply printing the results. So this is how you can utilize classes in a separate package, or you can have in the same package. You have the methods, you're passing the parameters, and it is returning you the result. These results you are storing and you're using it. So as we know, dynamic calculator have two methods that are non-static. But let's revise our old topics. I have one static method as well. So let's say public. It will return me public, let's make it static, and return type will be string, and method name get my full name. So this name will accept two arguments. First argument will be first name, second argument will be last name. I will take one string variable, I will say full name equal to whatever first name we will accept plus whatever last name we will accept, semicolon, and we will return from here. Now in this class, which is dynamic calculator, I have one static method and two non-static. So if I go back to this class, and this time if I want to call static method, I will directly say dynamic calculator dot get my full name Mukesh. So as we know, the return type of this method will be string. You can see it will return your string, and I will store this in a variable. I will say full name. And I will say congrats. Full name. So this is how you can keep everything. You can combine all the topics which you have learned till now. We have static, non-static, we are returning the value, and we are doing the parameters in integer format, double format, string format. So my main intention to cover as much as possible. So you can also try all these different ways. Okay, so it's printing, your program is working fine. And one more thing, let's say you want to add a gap. So you can give in this way. So now if you run this program, it will give you. So now you got the importance of returning the value, passing parameters, and the usage of it. So we will implement the same in our framework. So thank you so much. If you have any doubt, you can comment below. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.